morning, church.
Good morning.
Thank you for gathering here today. I welcome you in the grace of our Lord in person and online to worship and praise our Lord together. I believe that the Holy Spirit is dwelling among us for this morning. So we will experience the presence of our Lord, our Holy Spirit. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen. Let me share several announcements. There is a prayer meeting this Wednesday, 6:30 p.m. I believe that prayer is to be persistent activity before God. So I believe that when we pray together, we will experience God's miracle in our lives. Please come and pray together. If you find it difficult to drive at the night, please let us know. We will give you a ride to come prayer meeting. We will have VBS on August 5th, 10:30 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Please participate in VBS as much as possible to help educate our children. Amanda, do you have...
We're going to be collecting change again this year. We'll have some change for the kids that don't have change. But if you think about it, just, you know, search through your sofa cushions, get you a little bit of change and bring it, and we'll throw it in our jug. Thank you. Oh, and wear something that you don't mind getting wet.
Thank you, Amanda. The men's meeting will be held on August 9th?
6.
At 7:30 a.m. Please come and enjoy a delicious breakfast and fellowship together. Lemonade will be served again on August 6th. We are thankful for everyone who is serving lemonade for church congregation, especially our children, Kellen, Soyeon, Sojun. You did a great job, and thank you for your hard work for the church members, and may God bless you all. We have an administrative council meeting on the 8th at 7 p.m. And on August 20th, we will have a backpack blessings before the kids start school. Young Christians are encouraged to bring their backpacks. We will have some time together praying and blessing our children. And school supplies for Catawba Elementary School will be collected during the month of August. If we collect school supplies, we will deliver them to the school. The type of school supplies needed include notebook paper, construction paper, glue sticks, crayons, and markers, and whatever you want to bring. And you may also bring in tissues, hand sanitizers, wet wipers, and paper towels for using the classroom. And I think tomorrow is Paul and Margaret's anniversary. Congratulations on your anniversary. And let me ask, how many years have you been married this year?
Long time. Okay.
47. Oh, almost my age.
Yesterday was Mike and Debbie's.
Mike and Debbie's baby
anniversary.
Yesterday? Oh, okay. Congratulations on your anniversary. And let's give them a big round of applause to celebrate. And Mike is returned to church. I'm really glad you're back at church. Even though he's feeling not good, he's serving at the church service. So thank you for your faithfulness for the church ministry. And please say hello after the service. And there is a newsletter for August. So at the worship service, please take one. Is there any other announcement? Philly, do you have any announcement? No?
Well, I can. We're going to have a staff parish Thursday morning at 10 o'clock. That's it, everybody?
Thursday morning.
Thursday at 10 o'clock.
Okay. Okay. Today, I would like to open our worship service with prayers. So, let's pray together. Gracious and loving God, as we gather in this sacred space on this blessed Sunday morning, we come before you with a heart filled with gratitude and joy. We thank you for the gift of this community, for the fellowship of our brothers and sisters, and for the opportunity to let our voices in song to glorify your holy name. Lord, we ask you to fill this place with your divine presence. As the music flows from our lips, let it be a sweet offering of praise and adoration, rising like incense to your heavenly throne. As each note resonates, may it touch the deepest corner of our hearts, lifting our spirit and nurturing our faith. In this time of worship, help us to remember that your love knows no bounds. Remind us that we are united in your grace, regardless of our differences or backgrounds. May this time of singing be a unifying experience, binding us together as a family of believers, guided by the teaching of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Dear God, as we sing, may you draw near to those among us who carry heavy burdens, comforting them with your peace. May your healing touch be upon those who are hurting, and may your wisdom guide those who seek direction in their lives. We thank you for the privilege of worship, for the freedom to express our faith through a song, and for the blessings you pour out upon us each day. Help us to always remember that you are the source of all we have and all we are. In the name of Jesus, our Savior, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I'd like to invite all of you to call to worship, opening hymn and opening prayer. Call to worship. Sisters and brothers, rejoice. We live sustained by God's presence and love.
Thanks be to God.
As we mourn the wounds of God's children,
God weeps with us.
As we give thanks for the brothers and sisters who have lived in faith,
God give thanks to us.
As we struggle for justice,
God struggles with us.
As we strive for peace,
God strives with us.
As we walk to build the beloved community,
God works with us.
As we offer our gifts to all,
God blesses us.
Sisters and brothers, rejoice.
Sustained by God's presence and love, we worship God.
Amen. Would you rise? Let's praise our Lord together with the song of 139, Praise to the Lord the Almighty.
Oh, my soul, praise the Lord.
with our opening prayer.
Generous God, you gave us our voices, no two the same. As you did with Abraham and Sarah, you can again touch our lives and they can become extraordinary. In your church, you have gathered us. In your community of common folk and complainers,
prophets and puzzled people, you have called us and made a place for us.
So let what we say and do here, what we ponder and decide here, be real for us and honest to you, as you prepare us for the life of the world in which you are praised. Amen.
And as he taught us, so now we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
You may be seated. For this time, let's turn to our neighbors and wave and say each other, God loves you, and so do I.
God loves you, so do I.
God loves you.
God loves you.
This time, I'd like to invite the children for the Young Christian time. Please come forward. Talking about commandment of God, commandment of Jesus. One day, Jesus was in the temple teaching the people who were gathered there. A group of religious leaders asked some tricky questions to Jesus Christ to embarrass him so that people would not listen to his teaching. One of the men asked Jesus, "Teacher, which is the greatest commandment from God? Which one do you think Jesus said was the most important? Could you share with what you think with me? Which one do you think Jesus said was the most important?" The most important is this: love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest commandment. How do you think we might show our love to God with our with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength? How can we show our love to God? Do you have any idea? Pray? Oh, that's right. That's a good suggestion. How about Sojin? Jim? How about Jim? 하나님을 어떻게 사랑 표현해요? How do you express your love to God? You can speak in Korean. Okay. That's good suggestions. Here are some ways that I thought we might show our love to God. Worship, prayer, singing praises, bringing our offerings, and giving thanks for all His blessings. Do you know what Jesus said next? Love your neighbors, right, Chase? Love your neighbors. He said the second is this, love your neighbors as yourself. How do you think we could love our neighbors? How could we love our neighbors? Here are some things you might not have thought of. You could treat them like you want, like we want to be treated. Be kind to them. Forgive them when they hurt our feelings. Be helpful in times of trouble. Be their friends. These are the commandments that Jesus thought were the most important. It isn't easy to keep those commandments, isn't it? So that's why we need God's help each and every day. We believe that if we pray, God will give us the heart to love our neighbors. Let's pray and ask Him to help to love as He has commanded us. Please repeat after me. Let's pray. Dear Father,
dear Father,
help us to love you.
Help us to love you.
With all of our heart.
With all of our heart.
And to love our neighbors.
And to love our neighbors.
As we love ourselves.
As we love ourselves.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Please stand for our offering to be presented to God. To read scripture related to the praise. I believe that God gives us these Bible verses before we praise together. May these words inspire us to praise God. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 14. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved. For you are the one I praise. Let's move on next verses. Pray Psalm chapter 42. As the deer pants for streams of water, so my soul pants for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When can I go and meet with God? My tears have been my food, day and night. Why men say to me all day long, where is your God? These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I used to go with the multitude, leading the processions to the house of God, with a shout of joy and thanksgiving among the festivities. Throne. Why are you downcast, O my soul? why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise Him, my Savior and my God. My soul is downcast within me, therefore I will remember you from the land of Jordan, the highest of Hermon, from Mount Mizar. Deep calls to deep, and the roar of your waterfalls, all your waves and breakers have swept over me. By day the Lord directs His love. At night His song is with me, a prayer to God of my life. I said to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why must I go about mourning, oppressed by the enemy? My bones suffer mortal agony as my foes taunt me, saying to me all day long, where is your God? Why are you downcast, O my soul? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise Him, my Savior and my God. This time, this is sing-along time. Let's make a joyful noise. Let us give glory and praise to God together. Could you share with us your favorite hymns? Four, six, to two. He's so sweet to trust in Jesus. We're gonna sing together. Verse one. Stand up for Jesus. Go tell it on the mountain.
So
In Christ there is no east or west. 548. Nothing but the blood. 362.
Thank you.
let's hold our same amount of time, and for this time, let's take a moment to have a mission report. We're going to have mission report from Methodist men's meeting. So I invite Todd for the mission report of men's meeting.
Thank you, Pastor. Good morning, buddy.
Good morning.
There's a certificate posted on the wall of the Family Life Center. That is the original charter for our Methodist men's group. It was awarded in November of 1958, and it includes 35 signatures of the men who were the members of the very first Methodist men's group here at Catawba. A banner at the top of that charter reads, "Be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only." That scripture from the book of James still serves as the mission statement for our men's group as we strive to find ways to serve God by serving others as Christ expects us to do. The signatures include members of many of the families who make up the solid foundation of Catawba United Methodist Church and who are such an important part of our history. Fred Pope, Joe Spencer, Haskell Sharp, Jerry Sharp, Mr. Glenn Martin, and many others. Through the years, the men's group has worked hard to live up to the legacy and the expectations that were passed to us by these legends. We continue to meet almost every month to enjoy fellowship, to support each other in our faith, and to seek ways to serve our people in our church and our community. Sadly, our numbers no longer compare to those of the first years. Since the pandemic, we average about 12 who regularly attend our meetings, and of those, only 8 are members of our church, including our pastor. But though we are few in numbers, we are mighty in our efforts to try to do good and to bring help wherever we can. We always start our meetings with a wonderful breakfast. Then we have a very special devotional time shared by different members as part of our meeting. And then after reviewing our monthly expenses and financial status, we discuss service projects and ways that we can serve others. Those projects have included wheelchair ramps for those whose health status and mobility issues have changed. We also do yard work and home repair. We've even cleaned gutters. There was a winter morning a few years back when we were helping with some yard work, and we noticed the gutters were terribly filled with debris and dirty. And we also learned as we got up there that they were also filled with ice. It was a cold winter morning. But we have our own MacGyver in our church, if you didn't know that. Philip Spencer can find a solution to almost every problem. If there's not a tool, he will create a tool. So suddenly he goes home and comes back with this propane blowtorch, and he fires it up and starts thawing out those gutters. And it really worked. We were able to get the ice melted and the debris taken care of. But we also caught the gutters on fire. we had to fix that too. We've not been asked to clean gutters since that time. We also complete work around the church and the FLC and the parsonage. We do minor repairs and yard work and some painting under the direction of Mike. We sponsor the street cleanup at least twice a year to pick up the trash along the adjacent streets of our church. And we almost always get help from other members of our church to do this, not just the men's group. Throughout the year, we have some recurring events that we sponsor or assist with, beginning with our New Year's luncheon, usually the first or second Sunday of the year. This is donation only and is always led by Chef Jeff for our kickoff luncheon. We assist with the Plates of Love Outreach Ministry, getting groceries and preparing and packaging the meal. And one of the really nice things about Plates of Love is that several different people have taken lead in preparing that. Miss Ko Hae-sung has prepared a wonderful Korean dish, and just recently, Carol and Freddie led the group by preparing what is now the famous Sharp family casserole that was enjoyed by so many. We have really enjoyed being a part of the Plates of Love ministry that was envisioned and initiated by Debbie. In March or April of each year, we enjoy preparing and serving the Easter Sunrise Service breakfast led by our other masterful chef, Philip. We used to prepare for between 80 and 100 people when we were doing that service in conjunction with the Baptist Church, but now we're down to about a third of that number, but we still find it a very special time. Several years ago, Ronnie Brown connected us with the Rifle Range Group, and we have been providing their meal for their annual spring meeting every April. Our women's group also joined us in that effort, and we share the profits from that meal equally with them. It is still our single largest fundraising effort every year. We're proud to honor our mothers every Mother's Day with the gift of carnations, and each spring we continue to award a $500 scholarship to be used by a church member for furthering their education. In the fall, we help prepare the hot dogs for the town's fall festival event, and we host the Bunker Hill football team and cheerleaders and their coaches for a pregame supper, usually in October. Several of us support the Bandies programs and their athletes. And one year, we actually did the pregame for the Bunker Hill team on the night they were playing Bandies. Now, the rumors that somebody put X-Lax in that chicken Alfredo, I promise you, is fake news. We thought about it, didn't we, Freddie? But it didn't happen. The women's group always helps us with that, too. For Christmas, we continue to continuing the tradition of providing the treat bags for our young Christians and our old Christians. And we are honored to get gifts for at least one of the Angel Tree students each Christmas. Last year, we were blessed to have the opportunity to provide gifts for an entire Angel Tree family. We have great leadership currently with Jeff Hendren as our president and Spencer as our vice president. We are a proud part of Catawba United Methodist Church, and we hope to continue the tradition and the legacy of those saints who have gone before us as we strive to fulfill the covenant that we have all accepted as Christians and as Methodists to love and to serve others. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you.
Thank you, Hal, for your vision report, and thank you, Masters and Men's Meeting. As always, your love is reaching many parts of the church. We always appreciate your ministry and your effort in taking good care of church members and building the kingdom of God. At this time, let me read the Bible again. God gave us today. Psalm chapter 28, verse 6 to 8. Praise be to the Lord, for he has heard my cry for mercy. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and I am helped. My heart leaps for joy, and I give thanks to him in song. The Lord is my strength of his people, a fortress of salvation for his anointed one. Psalm chapter 33, verse 1 to 3. Sing joyfully to the Lord, you righteous. It is fitting for the upright to praise him. Praise the Lord with the harp. Make music to him on the ten-stringed lyre. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully and shout for the joy. Amen. Let's start again praising God together. Could you share with us your favorite hymn again? Okay, let me start. 5:26, what a friend we have in Jesus. Jesus loves me. There's something about their name, 171.
Jesus, keep me near the cross.
Breathe on me, breathe, O God.
Four.
because he lives, he lives, he lives, he lives.
Yes.
364.
This is a page here.
Oh.
Religion, though.
That's right. I guess it's. When we all get to heaven.
Thank you.
Dear God, we praise you today with our hearts and songs. We praise you for your faithfulness. We praise you for your great power and love. We confess our need for you. We struggle and worry, get weary and worn. Yet we believe you never leave us. Thank you for your presence today. Thank you for your care over us. Thank you that you breathe renewal right into our souls through praising you. We ask for your spirit to fill us, to draw us close to yourself, and to walk your purposes through us as we set our eyes on you. Father, as we dismiss, may the peace of God, the Father, the grace of Jesus, the Son, the guidance and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen.
Okay.